Hello guys, welcome to BuddyDevelopers once again, and in this video we will see the next add-on of Geodirectory called claim listing add-on. So this add-on give us a facility to claim a listing in Geodirectory. We will explore this add-on and the setting of this add-on in detail in this video. So let's start. So I already have a membership, so I will go here in my account and click on my account, and then here I will search for the claim add-on. Yeah, this is the add-on. I will click on this GIF file and this add-on got downloaded. So I'll go in my plugins section and click on add new, then click on upload, and let's choose the zip file that we have downloaded. Let's install this and let's activate it. So once this plugin got activated, we'll go in our Geodirectory in settings, and there you will find a claim listing tab. So let's click on this tab and see what are the settings. So as you can see, there are two tabs. In this tab you will see all the pending, approved and rejected claim request. As an admin, you only have this access to this particular screen, and then you have the setting tab where the actual setting of this claim listing add-on. Alright, so there are only two settings. So you know, auto approve via email verification. If you tick this setting, then whenever user will fill a form, they will get a email confirmation. Once they confirm their email, then automatically the listing will be claimed. But we don't want this, because in this case there are less chances that a real owner will claim their listing, because anytime anyone can claim that particular listing. So this is not a valid setting in my as per my opinion, I'm saying. Then, so there is this other setting which is auto approve on payment received, or the second way is if there is no payment, then it will be manually approved by the admin. So this is the good way, I think. In this case, as a listing owner, you can earn some money from the claimer or the real author of that particular business or listing. So let's save this and go with this setting for now. So now, in order to set up this plugin, first we will go to the CPT and then in the settings, and then here you will find one more field called claim field. So let's add this field. So what this field do is it will keep track of claim and unclaimed listing. So by default all the listing are unclaimed, so let's keep it unchecked, and then we'll select the packages here because I want to enable it for free package. Let's save it. And the second thing that we will have to do here is now to add that button where we want that claim listing button. So what I want is here on the detail page, I want here in the header section the claim button. So for that I will go here in the pages, and then I will find my detail page. So let's click on the detail page edit, and here basically I want that button below this tag. So I will click on this plus icon and search for my button called claim button. Let's add this short code here, and by default this title is claim listing. Let's keep it like this for now. Let's update the button. So let's update. So then we will go here in the archive page, and here if I click any of the listing, so on the detail page you can see there is a button called claim listing. By clicking on which, a user can fill up a form and just send a request to admin to claim this listing, this particular listing. So let's try once. I will go here in the incognito mode, and what I will do is I will logged in with other user that I have. Let's try without any user first. So I'll go here and I will click on this particular listing. So what I'm doing here is I'm claiming this particular listing without being logged in. So if I go for claiming it, so it redirects to login page. That means I will have to be logged in before I claim any particular listing. So let's because I don't have any account, let's create an account for claiming this particular listing. So for that I will create a user. Now let's log in with this user. So once I'm logged in, as you can see, the form has been reappear here. So I will just fill up this form as the owner of this particular listing. As you can see, there is an option to custom write this message, but let's keep it default. So here we have a message that your request to claim a listing has been sent successfully and you will be notified by emails once the decision has been made. So that's it. The claim process has been completed from the user. And now if I again go and look for claiming it, as you can see, there is a message that it looked like you already claimed and your claim is pending. So let's go back to the admin dashboard here. So for that, I will go in the Geodirectory setting and then refresh the claim tab that I have. So there you can see a notification and there is a new pending thing is appear here, and here he can review all the claim that has been requested by different people. So as you can see that this particular listing request has been claimed by a user called Rinku, and then this is the detail of that particular user. Also the user is here, so he admin can see about the validity of this user. So once admin has approved, okay, this particular listing is belong to this particular user, maybe he can manually contact to this particular user, or he can check the background or information that has been provided here. So he will click on approve. Are you sure you want to approve the claim request? Okay. So once this claim request has been approved, it appear here in the all section and in the approved section. So if I go here in the listing of this particular listing which has been claimed recently, and I will scroll down to see the author of this particular listing. So there you can see the place author has been changed to Rinku Giri now. So if I refresh this page again, or as any user, so as you can see that claim listing button is not appearing here. So that means this particular listing is claimed already. And if you scroll up here, you will notice that mark this listing as claimed has been checked. But let's check the other listing that I have, whether this is what is happening for them. To see this, let's click on edit of this particular listing. So when I will scroll down to the author section, as you can see, the default admin is the author of all the listing. And also if I scroll up here, you can see the business claim field is unchecked here. That means that this particular listing is not claimed yet. So if I go here in the front end, I will refresh the page. So there you can see this claim listing button is appearing for the listing that has not been claimed yet. And as a user, if I go for claiming it, I have the option. And one more thing, guys, you have option to customize this particular form. So if you go in the plugin section, if you have the Ninja form active, you can go in the Ninja form and click on add new. And there basically you will find a template called Geodirectory claim form. You can click on this and you can convert your claim listing form into a Ninja form and do whatever field you want to add in that particular form. So that is what you can do here. So let's just publish it, because it's a template that has been created by Geodirectory for the Ninja form users. So there is this short code. You can copy this, or let's go to the detail page. Okay, here. So guys, this particular short code, it's rendered the default claim form that has been created by Geodirectory. You cannot customize that form. So in order to use the form that we have created in Ninja form, there is an option, you can search here Ninja, and there you will find a Geodirectory shortcode for Ninja form. Let's click here and select the form which we want to render. So we want the claim form to be rendered, and there are advanced settings. So let's see what are the advanced settings that we have. Okay. So instead of this, let's make it claim form. Okay. And whether we want the output to be button or the form or link, whatever you want, I just want it to be button. And then you have the option to customize the design of that button. Let's save it. And now let's refresh the front end page to see the button. Okay, since this listing is already claimed, it's not showing that. So let's close this. Let's check this particular one. So there you can see, there is a button. This is the default form button, the default form that Geodirectory provide us. And this particular claim form is the ninja form, and there you can add whatever field you want to add by customizing your ninja form in the backend. So here we have covered the claim listing add-on of Geodirectory. If you have any doubt, any query, just put them in the comment section. I will reply to them and we will sort them out. So thank you so much and have a good day.